Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com with an update on injured guard Gabe Vincent and his pending return to the Los Angeles Lakers. First, quick reminder, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Going to keep you up to date on everything about the Lakers playoff push as we get closer to the end of the season. So Gabe Vincent was the Lakers' big signing of the summer in terms of new guys coming in. They spent most of their mid-level exception on him, hoping that he could give their backcourt a bit of a boost coming from the Miami Heat. And, well, it's not gone according to plan. He's appeared in five games this entire season, dealing with knee injury. And in those five games, he's not exactly been great. He's shooting 12% from three, and I'm rounding up in order to get there. He's been underwhelming, to say the least, but could he return to the fold and give the Lakers a boost heading into the postseason? Well, according to Shams Charania of The Athletic, Vincent is now targeting a mid to late March return. Now, we had heard over a month ago from Jake Fisher of Yahoo that the Lakers were hoping to get Gabe Vincent back in early March, this first week of March. Well, we're here, and obviously Gabe Vincent is not back. Obviously, that timetable has moved a bit. Shams Charania now saying mid-March to end of March. But of course, that begs the question, should they bring him back at all? Is it worth it to bring Gabe Vincent back? Let's say that this timeline ultimately lands somewhere late March. Let's say it's the end of the month. Well, the Lakers wouldn't even have that many games left on their schedule at that point. So do you have time, if you bring Gabe Vincent back towards the end of this month, to number one, get him up to speed? It takes a little while once guys get back on the floor to get their rhythm, get their timing, all of that. Get him to where he needs to be, and then reintegrate him into the Lakers rotation. Get everybody used to playing with him again. They haven't played with this guy in months. He's barely played all season, so there is going to be a little bit of a learning curve. Can you afford that heading into the postseason? Once again, Gabe Vincent was fantastic in the playoffs for the Miami Heat, so maybe you look at that and you just say he's a playoff performer. Let's at least get him into the mix. But it's fair to wonder, especially with Spencer Dinwiddie now in the fold, essentially replacing Gabe Vincent. The Lakers were able to get him on the buyout market. And while Dinwiddie has not been great for the Lakers in his stint, he did just turn in his best performance in the purple and gold last night in a win over the Thunder. He did a great job defensively on Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. So if the arrow continues to point up for Spencer Dinwiddie, is it even worth bringing Gabe Vincent back, or are they better off just calling this season a wash and looking ahead to next season? However, there is another angle to this beyond just the difficulties of reintegrating Gabe Vincent at the last minute right before the playoffs. The Lakers, they're known to be a team that's going to be active on the trade front this summer. We've already heard names like Trae Young, perhaps Donovan Mitchell, Kyrie Irving, some other guards that they might be interested in. Well, Gabe Vincent next season is going to be making $11 million. While Gabe Vincent himself probably doesn't have a lot of value given how poorly this season has gone, that number could be very useful in a trade package. So for the front office, it might be useful to have Gabe back out on the floor before the end of this season so that potential suitors can see that he is now healthy, he is ready to go, and they can hope that he'll bounce back to form next season. So that's the other angle to this. Beyond just the difficulties of putting Gabe back into the Lakers lineup late in the season, might it actually help the front office to prove that Gabe Vincent is healthy and ready to go for next season in their trade negotiations? Because again, we know they're going to be in the thick of things this summer. So a lot to factor in here. If Gabe Vincent is going to return to the Lakers, the hope has to be that it can be closer to mid-March, give them a little bit more time to potentially reintegrate him into the lineup, and then we'll have to see if he can actually return to form or if we're going to see the Gabe Vincent that we saw in, again, a tiny sample size, but the guy we saw in five games who shot less than 12% from three. We know that's not what he is. That's not what he showed last year with Miami Heat, but so far, this has been a disaster of a season for Vincent and the Lakers. Can he come back and right that wrong in time for the playoffs? Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Is it worth it to even bring back Gabe Vincent at this point? Or should the Lakers just say that ship has sailed? We'll see you in September for training camp. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.